In this tutorial, we'll go over how to use conditional access policies to enforce device trust for your fleet of devices. Use conditional access policies to implement zero trust security in your organization. To get started, navigate to the Security Management section in the JumpCloud admin portal and select Conditional Policies. To create a conditional policy for device trust, select the green plus icon. There are many variations of how you can use these policies to enforce device trust. In our example, we're going to be setting up a policy to restrict access to the user portal for any device that is not currently managed by JumpCloud. Select User Portal. Enter a policy name and description. Under Assignments, you can decide if you want the policy to affect all users or select users. Optionally, you can add conditions based on device, disk encryption, IP address, or location. If you set multiple conditions, you can use the drop-down to select whether to require any or all conditions to be met. In this example, we'll add a condition based on device. There will be two options for the operator, either the device is or is not JumpCloud managed. In this scenario, I want to deny access to the user portal when a device is not managed by JumpCloud. Under Action, I can either allow or deny access based on my assignments and conditions. If I allow access, I can also require MFA during authentication. Note, if you require MFA for users who have not already set up MFA, they will be prompted for MFA during authentication. It's best practice to have users enrolled into MFA before enabling this option. For this example, I will choose to deny access to the user portal for users who are attempting to authenticate from a device that is not managed by JumpCloud. Select Create Policy. Now that the policy is applied, let's see the end user experience when authenticating from a managed device versus an unmanaged device. I have a macOS device that is currently managed by JumpCloud's agent, as well as the user account Bill Green, which we'll be using in this demonstration. Opening a browser of my choice, I will attempt to log into the user portal from this managed device with Bill Green's credentials. We can now see that I've successfully logged into the user portal and have access to the SSO applications Bill has access to on this managed and trusted device. Let's replicate the workflow on an unmanaged device to show the denial of access based on the policies we've configured. Logging into Bill's account on a non-managed Windows machine, I attempt to log in and replicate the workflow. As we can see, even though Bill has valid credentials, we've set the policy to enforce denial of authentications from non-managed devices. If we were to change the policy to require MFA for non-managed devices, Bill could authenticate to the user portal from this non-managed Windows device, but MFA would be required for access. There are so many ways to utilize and configure conditional access policies. To learn more about conditional access policies, check out our Help Center articles.